Pige vizuri sasa.
Shh.
Pillo.
Pillo. No, 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 no,
no, no, no,
where we are now, we are at Sand River and we are just watching wildebeest crossing. And when you see, there are very few tourists, but the one you see right here, the residents that are watching the wildebeest crossing, great migration going on. The COVID-19 actually, they are really affecting the tourists, and that's why now this time of the year, the migration, they are here and there's no tourists because of the COVID really affecting all over the world. What I just want to tell the world is to be patient, and we have to put our measures which came from the health And what are we going to, we are going to tell the people to follow the rules which are the government put them in the place. They are actually following rainfalls and they are mating here in the Masai Mara.
Actually, COVID-19 has affected the tourism industry. As Sandra has just said, but although we hope that we shall travel again.
Mainly us as guide depends on working in camps, but we are so much affected. Most of us have no jobs. We are struggling in feeding our families. So COVID-19 has actually impacted a lot of things in our life, especially as guides. Not only us, but everybody who lives around the Mara depends on tourism. But because we don't have guests around, it has really, I can say, caused a lot of problems to us. Like no one is working, no one is. Most camps are not paying people. Some are on half pay, which is good. So definitely we have experienced tough times in COVID-19. A message to my colleagues, let us adhere to the rules, to the COVID-19 rules that we are given by health organizations. Like we put on masks, like I have my mask here, some other colleague of mine, I urge you to put on the mask, hand sanitizer, like I got mine here. I'm sure that camps will provide hand sanitizer if camps will be open. So my message to my colleagues, let us adhere to the rules. Put on mask, put on mask, social distance. Your priority is for your guests to be happy and observe the rules.
My name is Jackson Leintoy, and I'm the manager of Maclear Bush Camp. And this year it has really been different. Like this month, we used to be quite very busy. This is July, and we're going towards August. This is normally full season. Like last year, moments like now, we are full. We could have been full house. And if you look at it now, no clients at all because of this COVID-19. And we've really been trying all along. The company has really been trying to help our staff. All our permanent staff are still there. And they are paying us, all of us, half of our salaries, 50% all along. Yeah, we have basically been, this season has really been very bad. We don't really know if the government were going to do something because the tourism sector, I think, is the most affected. That's what I can tell, because you can look at the Mara. We have more than 230 camps, and all of them are reading zero. And, you can imagine the situation. And the migration has just started as usual. It's really getting started quite very nice. But now driving all the way to the normal crossing point is really difficult. All the roads are closed. There are no roads to go through because it has not been passed for the last 4 months. So I think, I don't really know what will happen after the president speaks, but if the situation is going to be like this, I think this sector is going to be the most, and they're already affected. The wildebeest migration has already started. There's no more, wild animal. They don't really know we have corona. So, they're already there in the Mara, and there are no clans. So, they're all over like normal, and you can go one car, and you can stay there the whole day. And normally, when you get any crossing point, you get more than 1,000 cars. The park authorities normally has to be there to do the control. It's quite different like this time around. Only the migration, and you can see them crossing all over, doing their normal activities, and there are no clients at all. No clients at all. But I think we are more than the hotels in the Mara. I think I can say we are ready. We were in Kirkrock the other day. We were tested, as we are requested as a guidance from the Ministry of Tourism. all our staff are tested, and even most of the camp, not only our camp. And we are still waiting them to give us the certificates. And we put all the requirements in place, what the Ministry of Government have said. You know, normally we want, apart from couples, each of our tent from this camp, we want one client per tent, unless couples. And in our dining tent, we want to take half of our client. We normally, our capacity is 30 pax, but this time around, we want to feed in our dining tent, half of that, you know. We are maintaining all the social distance. In our entrance, we have the hand sanitizer upon arrival, contact-free, and we have all the washing basins all in the camp. We have the thermal gun. Once you get in, all the system and all the requirements the Ministry of Tourism and Ministry of Health have asked of doing, we are ready and we are prepared for that.
Maybe what is your message to us?
Like my fellow hoteliers, I ask them to do the same. You know, make sure that what the Ministry of Health are telling us to do, let's all try and follow them, the rules and the regulations.